Hey everyone, today I want to talk about one of my favorite superfoods, broccoli. Now, why is it one of my favorite superfoods? Firstly, because it can be helpful for so many systems within the body. It can be helpful for liver health, immune function. Studies have shown it to be preventative for certain types of cancer. It can slow the aging process. It can help with your eyes, your joints, your lungs. It's fantastic in so many ways. Secondly, because it's one of the very few vegetable superfoods that I can get my two little boys to eat. They're fine with berries and cherries and nuts and seeds. They're not so great about dark leafy green vegetables, but I can get them to eat broccoli. In fact, when I ask them, okay, which vegetable would you like with dinner tonight? Sometimes they actually ask for it. So let's talk about eight reasons why broccoli is such a powerful superfood. In a famous book called How Not to Die, broccoli is mentioned more than any other food. Broccoli is a nutritional powerhouse full of vitamins, minerals, fiber, and antioxidants. 1 cup, about 90 grams, of raw broccoli contains about 6 gram carbs, 2.6 gram protein, 0.3 gram fat, 2.4 grams of fiber, 135% of vitamin C. We'll talk more about vitamin C here in a moment. 11% of vitamin A or beta carotene, 116% of vitamin K, extremely important for bone health. Folate, 14%, potassium, about 8%, phosphorus, about 6%, selenium, about 3%. So it is packed full, not only of vitamins and minerals, but important sulfur metabolites and compounds that we'll talk about here momentarily. So broccoli is a cruciferous vegetable. It's in the brassica family, similar to kale, cabbage, Brussels sprouts, cauliflower. Now, many of those other foods in the brassica family contain similar compounds, but broccoli is the star, no doubt about it. Overcooking can bring out more of the sulfur and bitter flavors and reduce the vitamin C content. So do not overcook your broccoli. For me at home with my boys, I steam it lightly or I add it to soups and stews. They eat it up. Cooking techniques such as adding a little bit of fat, coconut fat, olive oil, a little bit of sweetness, honey, just a touch of honey goes a long, long way. Or strong flavors like garlic, and roasting them in the oven, which can bring out natural sweetness, can all enhance the overall flavor or taste of broccoli and block the bitterness. So what are those eight conditions? Liver health, immune health, cancer, low density lipoproteins or LDL cholesterol, cataracts, osteoarthritis, asthma, and aging. We'll talk about each of them here in a moment. The applicable parts of broccoli are the above ground parts. Broccoli contains compounds, sulfur compounds. One is glucosinolates, such as glucoraphanin and glucobrassicin. Glucosinolates are metabolized into indoles and isothiocyanates. Now, that's important because until you cook or digest broccoli, it does not change into the active compounds. For example, glucoraphanin is metabolized to sulforaphane during preparation and digestion, and glucobrassicin is broken down into indole-3-carbinol. Pay attention to that, indole-3-carbinol. That's a special metabolite, if you will, of broccoli that has in research shown to be protective against the development of certain types of cancer. Some research suggests the bioavailability of sulforaphane may be greater in uncooked broccoli than cooked compared to, say, indole-3-carbinol. Storage of broccoli negatively affects and reduces the glucoraphanin content. Moreover, food preparation methods such as grinding, steaming, and adding to soups increase the availability of indole-3-carbinol from broccoli. So In certain instances, you may want to eat it raw. If you're after that indole 3-carbinol, you'll want to cut it, chop it, and lightly steam it or add it to soups. Certainly avoid high heats, such as in stir fries. Now, epidemiological research suggests that the consumption of broccoli reduces the risks of various types of cancers. Furthermore, in laboratory research, broccoli extract inhibits the proliferation of tumor cells. The anti-cancer effects of broccoli are likely related to two main groups of constituents, the indoles and the isothiocyanates, formed from constituents during preparation and digestion of broccoli. The isothiocyanates seem to inhibit phase 1 detoxification pathways in the liver and induce cytochrome P450 system phase 2 enzymes in the liver. Conjugating enzymes, you don't need to worry about that. So they can somewhat inhibit phase 1 and speed up phase 2 detoxification, which is what most of us need. For most of us living in Western society, our phase 1 is just going out of style, crazy fast, and phase 2 can't keep up with it. So eating broccoli slows down that phase 1, speeds up the phase 2, so we're able to push more to phase 2 and eliminate those toxins from the body, which may provide cancer preventative effects. Broccoli's effects on phase 1 and phase 2 detox enzymes may also contribute to its powerful antioxidant activity. Broccoli is also a good source of selenium, which might specifically have anti-cancer activity itself. One indole in particular, that indole 3-carbinol, might be particularly helpful against hormone-dependent cancers such as breast cancer. Indole 3-carbinol induces cytochrome P450A1A phase 1 detox enzymes, which alters estrogen metabolism, which is really important if you are at risk for developing breast cancer. Estradiol, or E2, is normally metabolized to both 16-alpha hydroxyestrone and 2-alpha hydroxyestrone. The 16-alpha hydroxyestrone metabolite has both genotoxic and tumorigenic effects, meaning it causes trouble with your DNA and it has the potential of speeding up tumor growth and is thought to increase the risk of breast and cervical cancers. Indole 3-carbinol shifts that metabolism of estradiol or E2 from 16-alpha to the weaker estrogen and more benign 2-alpha hydroxyestrone metabolite, possibly producing a protective effect against hormone-mediated cancers. The majority of evidence seems to indicate that indole 3-carbinol has a protective effect against cancer. However, there is some concern that it might enhance cancer progression in some cases. Since indole 3-carbinol induces phase 1 detox metabolism, it can also increase conversion of procarcinogens to their more active carcinogenic form. Ultimately, whether indole 3-carbinol has cancer protective effect or increases cancer risk in humans probably depends on several factors, as it always does in health, specifically cancer, including dietary factors and the duration and timing of exposure to indole 3-carbinol. For example, in animal models, there is some evidence that indole 3-carbinol has a protective role if administered before or in conjunction with another carcinogenic agent. If indole 3-carbinol is given after carcinogenic exposure during the initiation phase of tumor induction, it might act as a tumor-promoting agent and increase the risk of developing a tumor. Does that make sense? So if you're immediately exposed to something that might alter DNA and trigger the development of cancer, phase one needs to take care of that. But if you're speeding up phase one, that's a problem for the development and progression of cancer. By improving glycemic or blood sugar response, broccoli may be beneficial for patients with diabetes. Adding broccoli in one study, this was a cool study, adding broccoli to carbohydrate meals blunts the glycemic response to carbohydrates and improves glucose homeostasis. So clinical research in healthy patients showed that consuming two servings of broccoli in addition to mashed potatoes reduced the glucose peak, which I find really interesting. If you have broccoli with the carbohydrate, you're going to get less of a blood sugar response, less of an insulin response. Indole-3-carbinol also seems to have antiviral activity against herpes simplex virus, HSV. Scientists from the Linus Pauling Institute at Oregon State University recently found that eating broccoli and other cruciferous vegetables in the brassica family has more health benefits than taking a supplement containing similar healthy compounds, say standardized extracts of broccoli or specifically indole-3-carbinol itself. Eating the whole food, eating the broccoli, better than taking supplements which contain the same compounds. The researchers found that the enzyme called myrosinase is missing from most supplement forms of glucosinolates, a chemical in cruciferous vegetables that is linked with a reduced risk of developing prostate, breast, lung, and colorectal cancer. The myrosinase found in broccoli and other brassica vegetables help to break the glucosinolates into sulforaphane and uricin. Sulforaphane in particular may help to detoxify carcinogens and also activate tumor suppressor genes so they can perform their proper function. The researchers found that most supplements designed to provide glucosinolates have myrosinase enzyme inactivated, so sulforaphane is not released as efficiently compared to if you eat your broccoli. Researchers at UCLA reported that sulforaphane, a naturally occurring compound in broccoli and other cruciferous vegetables, may help protect also against respiratory inflammation that causes conditions like asthma, allergic rhinitis, and chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. So broccoli is a superfood. When it comes to vegetables, it's hard to top broccoli. Again, to summarize, helpful for liver health, immune health, cancer, LDL cholesterol, cataracts, osteoarthritis in some studies, asthma, and it can slow down the process of aging because, number one, it has antioxidant activity throughout the body, specifically in the liver, and it helps to increase phase 2 detoxification enzymes. All of those free radicals are eliminated from the body rather than flowing around the body and causing more damage, so it can slow down the aging process. I'm really impressed with broccoli and what the research shows about it. I'm really impressed that my two boys will eat it. I love it myself. So I'm with Zenith Labs. We have a website, zenithlabs.com. We have a Facebook page, an Instagram page, and of course, this YouTube channel. I encourage you to like this, subscribe to the channel, share it with your friends and loved ones, because each and every week we post at least a couple of videos so that you're better informed about how to achieve and maintain optimal health and wellness. Thank you so much for your time and attention. Dr. Ryan Shelton.